Back at Honda Center are the Ducks following a five-game road trip, and now it's the first of just two at home, and a couple of division battles begins here tonight with the Edmonton Oilers. Faceoff win for the Ducks, and Lindholm got a wrist shot towards the net, just to the right of Talbot. He reaches out, can't cover it up, still loose on the side of the goal. Good work by Cogliano. Kessler down low. Lindholm scores! Oh, and it was all made possible by the work of Cogliano and Kessler to the side of Talbot. They wouldn't let him cover up. And Hampus gives Anaheim the lead.
Oh, yeah, it hits an Oiler defenseman in front.
Connor McDavid the last four games, but he centers the second line for Todd McClellan tonight in part because he's had so much success against the Ducks. In his career, he's a point-per-game player. Here's Raquel alone in front, and what a glove save by Cam Talbot.
I think Raquel would tell you that he just did not elevate that puck as much as he wanted to. It's right into the glove of the Oilers netminder.
Career high 10, definitely within reach. He did that two seasons ago. Here's Kasha out of the corner of the Edmonton. Now bouncing and floating through the air. And Henrik turned the blade of his stick down and kind of backhanded it towards the net. Here's Raquel. And his shot blocked. Russell goes down. And Russell having trouble getting back up. The perennial shot blocker in the league. And what a redirect by Raquel through the legs.
He has got some kind of hand.
You know, the Olympics started yesterday. Maybe there's style points out there or something tonight. Into Clefbaum. Pass comes through, and Gibson got the stick on it, I think.
Now Wagner's got to cut that pass off. Chris Wagner's got to get his stick down in that passing lane.
To oppose McDavid. It's a win for Henry. To the slot. Here's Maroon point blank, and Gibson got a glove on it.
Boschman taps it back into the middle, and Pat Maroon gets a pretty good opportunity. Gibson, a short little challenge, didn't give him much space. Put a lot of force behind that hit.
Cogliano got up under his own volition. Here's a turnover, gets off ahead to Perry, he scores! Boy, the Oilers sloppy in their own zone, and the old combination of the Twins doubles the Anaheim lead.
Getzlaff bumps it ahead to Perry, and Corey Perry is looking 5-hole the whole way in a quick stick, 6 feet tall. So this doesn't look 200 pounds whenever I see it.
Puck gets away from Boschman. Here's Slepyshev. Backhand score! So a game that went 35 minutes with only one goal now gets two goals in just over 90 seconds.
Well, this is a big goal for the Oilers, and it comes off a turnover.
Russell on the backhand, gets it into the Anaheim zone. Lindholm is there. Uses the boards to get it by Puljujarvi, put it right back in front. Oh, a yawning net for McDavid. And sprawling to his right, Gibson able to seal it off. Good defense by the Ducks. Otherwise, McDavid just hoists that into the cage. He's on the year now for Kasha. Kessler pulls one off the side of the net, and Cogliano drops it off for Lindholm. Loads it to the net, tipped in! Silverberg and Kessler were there. The Ducks have a two-goal lead again.
I think it's Ryan Kessler that gets a touch on it. Happened in the opening minute of play. Since then, the Ducks have just put a blanket over everything.
He's got it now, and he's got it across to Russell, who scores! His second goal in as many games against the Ducks, and the Oilers are back within one.
Well, if John Gibson loses an edge, yeah, he can't get his edge into the ice.
And I have a feeling the Ducks are going to see a healthy diet of number 97 the rest of the way. McDavid extends his scoring streak. Ducks turn it over. Oh, Letestu had the tying goal on his stick. Or I beg your pardon, it was Slepyshev. It comes back through the crease. And I don't know how it didn't go in the second time. McDavid rolls it across the zone. But the horn will sound. And the Ducks have defeated the Edmonton Oilers tonight here at Honda Center by a final count of 3-2. So the Ducks, with back-to-back wins, come home and open a mini two-game homestand with a Pacific Division victory here tonight over the Edmonton Oilers.